Talk about some trailers.
Movie trailers coming at you. Okay.
So a couple of trailers came out this week.
X-Men Apocalypse, Star Trek Beyond, Independence Day Resurgence.
Wasn't there another Deadpool trailer this week?
Not yet. The Deadpool trailer is going to be released at the end of 12 days of that movie.
Ah, okay, yeah.
So we've just got a couple of really awesome pictures.
Pictures.
That we can't show you, but if you're a fan, or even if you're not, find Deadpool Movie on Facebook or Twitter, and you'll be up to date with all the latest, greatest, coolest Ryan Reynolds shit. At Vancini Reynolds, if you're curious.
Stuff.
So, I guess we'll talk about Independence Day later. Star Trek Beyond didn't really give me enough to fall in love with the movie whatsoever at all. I'm not even quite sure what is going on with the plot other than Spock and McCoy are still Spock and McCoy. Like, they still don't like each other a whole lot. So, like, that's the only thing I got from it.
My question is, why don't they do anything with, like, the Borg? They have the...
Yeah, but that doesn't even come along until the Next Generation, unless you were also watching Enterprise, and then you realize that they woke up frozen in the ice in Antarctica.
But you've altered the timeline. So that could have altered when the Borg
showed up.
Yes.
They could be saving that. I don't know what exactly they're doing with this one. It wasn't the best trailer I've seen. Like, because it gave me... It literally gave me
action.
Nothing.
There's a lot of action.
Yeah, but that was about it. I mean, if you want to talk the trailer that gave away the most of the film, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Hands down.
Oh, you saw that one too?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like it?
Loved it.
Michael Bay, man. You ruined your favorite.
You're show. Hating it already?
Yeah, no, I just don't like Michael Bay. I don't like Michael Bay.
I'm loving it, minus Megan Fox. I'm still not a huge... I'm not convinced.
Yeah, but we have Casey Jones, a.k.a. the Arrow.
Yeah, Amell. Mr. Amell. Yeah. Jesse, I showed her that trailer a lot. Actually, to distract him long enough to finish eating, I brought up all the movie trailers that we wanted to see and watched them in succession. That wasn't the one he was most enthralled by, but he did good. Do you want one? Do you want to pop?
Okay. I'm just trying to keep him distracted. He seems to like be calm whenever you're doing this.
Yeah, pet like a pet. Why is he just like it?
You never play with Jesse's hair just to make her happy.
Yeah, there was a time.
Okay, let's go trailer by trailer. First trailer, Star Trek Beyond. The action looks good. It looks good in that regard.
It didn't sell me on the film yet, though. I'm not sold. I'm gonna go see it. I saw the other two in theaters. I'm definitely gonna go see it.
The basics I got out of it is they're on the edge, of the brink of the frontier, and there's something happening on the brink of the frontier, either with the Klingons or like maybe even Romulans.
Some other race.
I think Romulans are kind of. They're not technically with the Federation, are they?
No, they've never been with the Federation.
They're not against them either, though.
They try to remain neutral as much as you can.
Because they're kind of related to the Vulcans.
Well, yeah, they're really pissed off at the Vulcans. Why? They're still pissed off at the Vulcans. From everything that happened in Enterprise, like, the Vulcans are spies and thieves according to the Romulans, which the Romulans are spies and thieves according to the Vulcans. Like, there's a whole lot going on here.
They both have the same ancestry, is what I'm saying.
Yes.
Yeah.
Both descended from the same original race.
But, yeah, okay.
It looks interesting, but it hasn't... It's not... I'm going to go see it, but it's not high on my priority list. Like, at the beginning of our first podcast of the new year, when we do our top 10 films we're looking forward to next year, it's going to be definitely...
Well, the top 10 films of 2015?
16.
15. 16. Ones we've already seen 2015.
At the beginning of the new year, we always do the films we're looking forward to most. That's
we should also do one and pick our top 10 films of the year that we already watched.
Then we'll have to do two at the beginning.
We will. That's awesome.
Awesome. You're gonna get.
Okay, so that's the first trailer we saw. They don't give you much on the plot. It seems like they're on the brink or on the edge of the frontier. Something's going on there. We shall see.
It hasn't sold me yet. I'm gonna go see it, but it's not high on the list.
Okay, so that's the first one. Second trailer, Ninja Turtles. I'm not gonna lie, it didn't look bad.
Rocksteady and Bebop. I'm sold, and it looks like a little Krang action going on with the dimensional rift open up above the city. Like, how else are you going to explain that? It's got to be Krang.
Now they need more of the... It's not a bad movie.
What?
It's not a bad movie.
Butters.
Hey, buddy.
Put your foot up. Kick your feet up.
Kick your feet up.
Get comfortable.
Hey, bud.
You want to play that?
I play that?
It says Hogwarts on it. Don't get AIDS from it.
Axis says in Latin, don't tickle the sleeping dragon. That's what that means in Latin, but it's something else for the school. That's what that means in Latin. What?
That's a little bit.
You're a little bit.
You're not playing with a keyboard. Last time you did that, Daddy took 15 minutes to get the book straight now.
And you pretty much sexted someone on Facebook.
Yeah, I don't even know who that poor girl was, but thank God she didn't get back to me.
No, Colin. I'm going to put that right there until you play that. You play that, but you need you can't play with my tablet. It's not mine. That's not super. Okay, so second trailer. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. They expose themselves to New York. I mean, Megan Fox, yeah, I mean, she's so hot. She's just a bitch. Stephen Amell looks awesome. That'd be a reason to see it. Let's see how good he portrays Casey Jones. Because Casey Jones from the original was pretty awesome. That's another trilogy.
If he maintains...
That's another franchise. I did not think to add to this list.
If he maintains playing only characters in anything that has something to do with the color green...
Or vigilanteism.
That would be an awesome career. Like, literally... Only if it has something to do with the color green. That would be awesome.
What's the next one? Toxic Avenger?
There's nothing wrong with the Toxic Avenger.
No, there's... Did I say there was? I'm just saying that could be the next
one. Thing.
Toxic Avenger.
Apparently, since Ryan Reynolds departed, Green Lantern needs somebody to play.
But they got Black Guy playing.
Oh, yeah, they're doing that.
Doing that version.
Well, that's okay. There's another one.
You got it, buddy.
Yeah. I'm not that racist.
Yeah, okay. So didn't look bad. Obviously, it's Michael Bay, so there's gonna be explosions and everything out the walls.
Yeah, they like to blow shit. He likes to blow shit up. Actually, his entire production team likes to blow shit up.
So we're gonna have you do this romantic comedy, low budget, just because of last explosions. It doesn't matter.
Just blow shit up. Just blow shit up. It's going to be awesome.
How about you broaden your range as a director? Okay.
How much better would that have made for getting Sarah Marshall and Michael Bay directing it? That would have been a great movie then. I would have loved it.
Yeah, you ruined it.
Ruined it my ass. You couldn't fucking ruin that movie if you tried.
I didn't think that movie was that bad.
It was terrible to begin with.
You're the one that hates The Hangover. You have no credibility with comedies.
What?
You have no credibility with comedies when you're saying that The Hangover, you didn't at least find any of it funny. You can hate the plot all you want, but that movie was hilarious.
It was remotely entertaining.
Jim Galifianakis. Yeah, Jim?
No, Zach.
Zach Galifianakis was goddamn hilarious in that movie. He was goddamn hilarious in that movie.
It was remotely entertaining.
Okay, sorry. Back to trailers. Any other trailers that we saw this were in the last few weeks, I should say. You had Apocalypse.
Yeah, X-Men Apocalypse. It's, man. Like,
there was a lot in that.
Like, literally, we could take an hour to talk about that trailer.
What it looks like is that... I think that might be your wife.
That is my wife.
Well, I think what it is you have the well, the Mystique looks like she's like some hippie. Like, she's running some kind of thing against Apocalypse.
Yeah, but Sansa Stark is Phoenix.
I know!
What?
Yes. I like how she looks. Like, very young Phoenix. I liked it. And you got young Storm with the mohawk.
I like that. That's very.
I'm guessing she's going to be one of the four horsemen. Colin, come on, buddy. Calm down.
Yeah, this is what doing a podcast with a baby is like. Yeah, fuck.
We may have changes to podcast.
Fuck that guy that thinks he's like Bat Dad, whatever. He only does his kids when they're fun. Like, he doesn't come around when they're angry and cranky. So, Bat Dad, I challenge you. Do an entire podcast with your kid the whole entire day when they're good and bad. And he's not being bad. He's just a baby. He doesn't know any better. I know. I know. I'm going to take you to that other person that you love a lot more than me.
Hey, what's wrong, bud? Hey,
we're united and it feels so good.
This. Oh, it's been fun. So anyway,
reunited and it feels so good.
Why can't we be friends? Why can't we be friends?
Okay,
that goes back to our Lethal Weapon
Apocalypse.
There you go.
It sounds like Magneto and
Angel,
Storm, and I don't know who the fourth one would be.
Yeah, or I gotta go.
Worst of the Apocalypse.
I gotta start back. I would have to go back and reread the comic in order to be a little bit fairly accurate on this one, but
I think he would probably want Professor X.
Well, but no, I think he lined up the four things he needs to take out the one thing that can defeat him, which would be X. I think that's where I think that's definitely the direction the film's going. But never mind that, because this is setting up the Age of Apocalypse. Period. Like, that's going to be what happens. Like, it's going to be a timeline jump shift again, which is fine for the X universe, which it did wonders for resetting it and making it right. Mm-hmm. So now we're going to go back and fuck it up and make it wrong. And then we're going to go back and set everything right by the end of the third film now, from this one.
Now, look, I didn't see this. Maybe you did. Was Wolverine was not in this, in the trailer at all, mm-hmm. right? I didn't see it at all.
Mm-hmm.
So the question is, is there going to be another X-Men movie in which he gets actually gets like his powers back? He's like the Animantium. And then is he going to be a part of Apocalypse?
Well, he's booked for a third Wolverine movie, so that's happening.
No, apparently that's his last movie as Wolverine.
Yeah, but they're doing Old Man Logan, is what I heard. I don't know.
I think he should just do the role. Just finish out what they're doing right now. This one and then one more X-Men movie.
This is a great story arc.
It is.
Like, if you wanted to do, like, when they screwed up the Phoenix story arc back in the third film, if they ever wanted to do that story arc properly, that is a three-movie story arc easily.
Mm-hmm.
Age of Apocalypse, three-movie story arc very easily. They set it up differently, but I understand comics to cinema, you got to kind of change shit up a little bit, but they have a chance. They have a chance here to pull off one of the greatest story arcs in comic history.
One of the best to actually play off would have been if Spider-Man would have actually gone through and done like a real, real good Venom. And then gone all the way to the Carnage. That would have been one of the best they could have really done.
Yeah, but they didn't. They tried to sum it up in one film that wasn't justified whatsoever. But like,
well, Venom part makes would it?
But Bryan Singer's back, so there's a chance. There's a chance. I don't know. I think it can be done properly. I think they can do the Apocalypse story arc properly. They just actually have to give a damn and try. Because you have it available to you. Read the Age of Apocalypse story arc. Read it. It's a combined total of like 28 issues. There's a lot of stuff to read into. And the lead into it, and this is easy enough for you because it's only 5 issues, is Legion Quest.
Did you see Gambit in the trailer?
No.
He's not in there.
Well, you talk about a trailer that flashed through a lot of shit real quick.
Yeah. I mean, it gave better plot points than
Star Trek Beyond.
Star Trek Beyond, I'll give you that, but I don't know, it's interesting to say the least. I cannot wait.
I'm more excited for the ending of this movie than I have been for anything in a long time. Because I want to see where they go from here. They have set it up. They have one of the greatest X-Villains of all time. They've got all the parts. One of.
I would say the, but.
Well, but I'm just saying. Like, they've got all the parts in play.
Everybody's there. They're still under contract. Do it justice. Do it justice. Wrap up with Age of Apocalypse. Everyone is begging for it. You know everyone's begging for it.
Well, you have a handful of actors that I think after this movie are kind of pretty, or after like one more movie are done. Like you have Jennifer Lawrence is, I'm pretty sure she's done with Mystique after this. I'm pretty sure. You have Jennifer Lawrence is done. Mm-hmm. Wolverine has, I think, one more. I'm not sure if it's one more Wolverine movie or one more X-Men.
One more Wolverine.
And then more X-Men.
I think, but he's one of those guys I think you'd be able to can talk into coming back from. For,
I mean, everyone's got a price. So.
For the role.
I mean,
just come back for the role. No big deal. You're not bound by anything. We're going to give you X million dollars to come back and.
I don't know, but you're talking about a guy who has a broad range of acting to where he likes to spread his wings.
Well, he's as pissed off at the first Wolverine movie as the rest of us are.
Well, so that probably, has to. He probably feels he wasted the earlier the Twilight, not Twilight, the baby years of his acting career.
I don't think he thinks he wasted it so much as like he went back. He's self-admitted that he went back and read Deadpool comics after the fact to get more familiarized with the character because he didn't do that before the film, and who blame him? It wasn't his problem. He didn't have to deal with it. He went back and read it. And he felt that Ryan Reynolds was done a huge injustice, which 20th Century Fox is fixing, thank God. So, I mean, he's one that takes the character seriously. He's impassioned about it. It's not just, I'm making money. Mm-hmm. It's what I mean, come on. He wouldn't have done The Boy from Oz as a musical if he didn't feel impassioned about the character. You're not going to do a musical about you being gay. Unless you love the character.
What, Les Miserables?
Well, yeah, and that too.
He's got a right. He's a triple threat, man. He can do it. He can sing, act, he can dance. He's a triple threat, man. He's got everything.
That's probably why he doesn't.
The thing is, doing like these kind of movies, like Wolverine, takes up a lot of time where you can't do those other projects you've always wanted to do.
Well, he didn't put himself in the same position that Thomas Jane did, where Thomas Jane flat out said, if I don't like. I'll sign your three film contract, but if I don't like fuck script, you can get fuck yourself. And Thomas Jane pretty much did that. And thank God he did, because he didn't want to attach to fucking Punisher Vengeance.
Yeah, Nobody did. That was atrocious.
Hell, everyone attached to that film wants to commit suicide. That was a fucking atrocity. But anyway, on to some happier news. Independence Day!
Or as I like to call it, Halo the prequel.
Doesn't matter. Don't care.
Dude, it's basically like that. If you think about it, it's basically like that.
Well, iRobot's a prequel to The Matrix, but that's besides one.
Maybe.
More than likely.
Maybe.
I'm sure there's a guy.
Diane.
I'm sure there's a guy who's got a theory, and I'm right about that, because if you ever watch the end of... Man, no, I'm not going to bore you, because we've already had this conversation like three times.
About what?
How the iRobot is the lead into the Matrix because of one of the mini movies in the Animatrix. We've already had this conversation.
No, I've never had that conversation.
We have had that conversation.
No, we have not.
I'm sure we've had that conversation.
You might have thought we had the conversation. Maybe you took the wrong pill, so you just have a recurring memory of something that never
happened. I really want to punch you in the face. Seriously, I want to punch you in the face. Anyway, simple fact is. Highlight of my weekend, tuned into Sunday Night Football, watching Sunday Night Football. Sunday Night Football's on, goes to commercial, see a bunch of UN trucks in movie trailer format, head through the desert. I'm like, what's that about? That's going to be a disaster movie of some sort. Now I'm interested. Turns out to be ID4 Resurgence. Thrilled to death. Even though they killed off Will Smith in 2007, which you didn't see, but I just spoiled it for you, so go to the website and find out for yourself. April 26th was his actual death date.
In the show?
Yeah, in the movie. Yeah. They do like a timeline from 96 up until now. It's a war at 1996 dot something. I haven't heard.
Yeah, I saw a video on it on YouTube. There's a video explaining a little bit of it. They didn't explain how Will Smith died, though.
Yeah, he's dead. Test flight of an alien aircraft. I just ruined it for you. Sorry about that. Anyway, he's not going to be in the movie anyway. They couldn't afford Will Smith, or Will Smith didn't want to do it. Doesn't really matter.
He probably has a lot of stuff on his plate right now.
Well, after Concussion, which probably filmed it very much a similar timeline as Independence Day Resurgence, so can't blame him for going for the Oscar nod versus the
action. Plus, he's like, he's filming Hancock 2.
Bad Boys 3 and 4.
Just 3. He's filming 3 now. But I mean, he's not filming 4 now. He's just,
they got planned for 4. I'd hope for that. But anyway. No, that's the one that really grabbed my attention over the weekend. And only because, I'm not a huge disaster movie freak. Like, I can watch some and just be like, okay, yeah, I saw Tommy Lee Jones at Volcano. Alright, I'm done with that. It's over. But I don't know, for whatever reason, Independence Day has always held a special place in the subcaucles of my itty little itty bitty black heart.
I actually loved that movie. I thought that movie was fantastic.
I mean, you can go back.
I still have the VHS cover, the hologram cover of the White House.
Where it blows up. Yeah, good business. Loved that movie. I'm so freaking geeked.
I just remember. You've seen Goldmember or not Goldmember? Austin Powers: The Spy That Shagged Me.
Yeah.
Remember where he's like, this is what my laser beam will do. And he's like on the moon. And he's like, ah! And like, I'm just kidding. That was a scene to abide for. That was a scene. My laser would be a lot like that.
I absolutely love that movie. Just some of the stupid little scenes in it where that girl's standing there at the top of the tower like,
Take me first, Elvis.
Well, yeah, that was one of the signs that was on there, but no, that one girl's like, take me first. They're like,
look, they're opening up.
We're going to blast you in hell and back. Like, just.
Well, I like what they're doing, that we use the alien technology to enhance our own and defend ourselves better.
Yes.
But so I'm curious if there's a universal, like, world, kind of like Star Trek, I guess, where, like, there's a global entity that is more cooperative than what we have.
You fuck with my little brother, I'm going to come fuck with you. Or, don't fuck with these guys. They already kicked your ass once. You don't need to do it again.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend.
Ah.
That kind of thing. That's an interesting way to look at it. Like, does the world have like some kind of uniform, or as what's it, or was it Bill Paxton?
I would like to see them have a
Bill Pullman. As he said in the movie, like when he gave his like speech,
holiday.
We can't be like, you know, torn by our petty difference. That was like one of the. That's one of the best like motivational speeches.
That was really really good. Today no longer celebrate
an American holiday.
We celebrate our Independence Day. Is like,
as one voice, we will not go quietly into the night. We will not vanish without a fight. Today we will live on. Today we will fight. Today we celebrate our Independence Day.
Brilliant! Those are commercials they need to bring back.
Man.
But no.
Man, I got like so many top tens going through my head right now. Get out your phone. I'm giving you a list of top tens that we're going to have like over the, and we're not like altering this, okay?
We're going to give that to the people?
We're going to tell the people. We got top tens coming up this next year, after this, like next week.
This next year.
This next year. The next 2016 is going to have top tens of this nature.
All right.
Okay, so we have the next one coming up is liquors and Christmas movies. And we're doing two, okay? Also next week, we are going to do it's a movie fantasy football draft. We will take football players from movies and draft them, and we're going to go back and forth and have like a real draft, and we're going to draft players on our team and have like a team.
I'm working on it. Okay, I type slow.
You're good. Okay. Then.
All right, that's done.
Okay. Top movies of 2015. As of next year, we're going to have our top 10 movies of 2015.
I got to do this.
Oh, you're good. Okay. And then we're going to do top 10 movies of 2016 we're most anticipated for. Or most excited, or geek to see. I know his, but.
I am so excited for that one. Man.
Yeah. Now, these are movies we saw in theaters, just movies in general?
Movies in general.
Okay. All right. 10 Bruce Willis movies.
Or we did.
No, we didn't.
Yeah, we did.
No, we did not.
Yeah, we did.
No, we did not.
Yeah, we did.
No, we did not. No, we did not. No, we did not. I promise you, we did not. You can look it up all you want. We did not do a top 10 Bruce Willis movies.
I'm pretty sure we did.
We thought about it. We talked about it. We never did it.
Why didn't we do it? That seems like something I would have pushed for.
We didn't. Can you just write?
Are you sure I didn't do this?
I promise you, man. We had this argument last week.
Yeah, we did. Right there's mine. It was podcast 10. Winning.
Are you sure? I'm pretty certain I looked that up.
It's podcast 10. It says podcast 10 right across the top of the screen.
Doesn't mean it happened.
It happened. Sure.
God, I could look it up and find out right
now. Okay, it doesn't matter, but I'm right on that. Anyway, pick another one.
Okay. Top 10 90s movies.
Ah.
90s movies? Top 10 football movies.
Wow, he's like loading us up for the rest of the year.
Oh, yeah. I got a lot. I've had a lot like in my mind that I just haven't like wrote down.
Now I'm going to have to go back and watch Brian's song because I feel like I'm missing out on something.
Okay, football movies. How about baseball movies? There's a lot of it.
No.
Do you want to do...
I don't like baseball enough.
Do you want to do animated kid franchises?
Animated franchises. That one I'm into.
I thought we had something like that, though.
I think we did, like...
Kids shows. Our favorite kids shows.
We did that, but we didn't do franchises. We were just like, stick with the shows themselves.
Okay.
Animated franchise movies.
I'm thinking here.
Why was I demoted this tonight?
Because you haven't. You keep track of them better than I do.
Well, I'm trying.
Also, my tablet kind of reset itself, so I lost our first like 30 podcasts on
here. Wow. See, I. The cloud.
The tree.
The cloud saves me.
Any more.
That's like 4 weeks into the new year.
So?
Well, we're taking a week off at the end of this year.
Yeah, I know. After next week, we got a week off.
Yeah, what we're doing next week.
Yeah, because we have, I get things all the way new year.
And I'm having baby time.
We have the next week.
Yeah, because I got 11 days.
We still have football. We still have football, so that's good. And we'll have a little bit of college football. And... Can you think of any like movie genre? Or how about, what do you consider, like, when you say disaster film, are we talking about, like, natural disasters?
All disasters.
Or movies that just sucked?
We already know.
Okay, do you consider ID4 a disaster movie?
Yes.
Okay, but that's not, like, a natural disaster movie.
Oh, you didn't specify natural.
Okay, it's just, I'm trying to understand your clarification.
What the fuck were you gonna do? Rank the 10 worst 90s disaster movies? Like,
other than 10 best, but.
There's no best! They all suck! Unless there's aliens involved.
Armageddon was not a sucky movie. Deep Impact was not horrible.
Great porn.
Dante's Peak. I actually enjoyed Dante's Peak. That's another disaster movie.
With that dude who played James Bond?
Yeah, Pierce Brosnan. And then the girl who played it, Sarah Connor. Don't hate on Sarah Connor.
Like, that's... Ugh, I don't know.
Damn, there's another franchise.
I don't know, like... Okay.
There's a lot,
like,
man.
The 20... What the fuck was the one where...
Okay, 80s action movie. There's another one. We haven't done... I don't think we've done top 10 comedy.
That's yet. Too similar to something we've already done. We do 80s action movies.
As an individual movie.
Because we haven't even done our franchises yet. And that's pretty much going to cover most of it.
How about top 10 movies of 2000?
All
right. We're having a lot of top 10.
I'm going to look over.
I don't want to get to the point where we eventually run out of stuff. I don't think that's
ever going to happen. How the hell do I... 2000 movies, period.
Yeah. Between 2000 and 2010. All
right.
The cutoff is 2010.
2009.
Or you want to go 2001 to 2010 or 2009? It's up to you how you want to do that.
We'll figure it out. I'm sure one of us will have something in a gray area. We'll have to debate it later.
Yes, but ID4 Resurgence looks awesome. I'm curious what's going to happen.
I'm geeked. I don't
know. Are they like the people that they, the aliens that they've already killed in the first one, are they like miners that go out and mine these planets and
yeah, and this is home? Like the Emperor class.
Yeah, and then now you're getting the rest of the civilizations like, fuck that planet. We're going to fuck that planet.
We ain't putting up with that shit. Ain't nobody
pretty much mind. Moves their entire franchise
fleet
whatever their franchise yeah their entire let's say it's like a damn planet or something just moves it and like we're gonna park next to Earth and we're gonna fuck your world up.
We're having Christmas and it ain't your time of year.
Yeah. God, I saw.
I'm geeked for that. I'm really geeked for that.
So am I. I gotta show you a cool video here in a minute after the podcast, of course. After the podcast.
Well, you're running out of time. Because you have to be at 7:30 at your apartment for pussy.
I have more than an hour.
For pussy.
Not pussy. I told you, possibly poker. If there's no poker, then maybe I'll get there will be pussy. That'd be a good move.
I wouldn't be interested in one without the other, to be honest with you, but that's besides the point. Have we elaborated on the fact that I am a terrible human being?
Not enough.
Hey, we're going to do a top 10 now.
We're going to go top 10. Ready? Top 10 movie franchise. Go.